मैम यू कैन स्टार्ट नाउ।
ओके सो गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन एंड वेलकम टू द ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन चैनल ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड सेकंड प्रेजेंटेड बाय ब्रुहन मुंबई महानगर पालिका। ओके सो टुडे इज 15 फरवरी एंड वेलकम एवरीवन एंड आई होप यू पीपल आर रेडी टू लर्न राइट। So now, before starting the subject and introducing you to the topic, I would like to introduce myself. I am Hina Mehboob Sheikh from Mumbai Public School, Dharavi Kala Kila, from G North Ward. Okay? So shall we start now? Are you people ready? Okay. So today we are going to deal with subject maths. Okay? Now in maths, right, learning math is really fun. Okay, so because in this we have to deal with numbers, different operations on numbers like multiplication, division, addition, and subtraction, right? But today we are going to deal with a new topic, that is reading pictures. Now students, have you heard about reading pictures? This topic we have already dealt in subject English, right? But there what we have to do, we have to look at the pictures and we have to answer the questions related to the picture. But in math also we have the same topic, okay, that is reading pictures. But in math what we have to do, we have to deal with the numbers, we have to interpret the data, we have to find out the answers according to the numbers in the picture. So, okay, the subtopic which we are going to discuss today is classification. Okay, so now what do you mean by the term classification? Do you know, children? What do you mean by classification? Yes. So now in this picture, as you can see.
Yes.
Yes, right? What do you mean by classification? Now I will give you some time. Just, you can see something on the screen, right? There are some pictures of some vegetables. So in according to this picture, we are going to term what out what the word classification means. Okay, so just observe the picture first.
Okay,
so observe the picture. Now in this picture, you can see there are some vegetables, right? There are some tomatoes. Yes, here you can see there are some tomatoes, there are some capsicums, and there are some brinjals, right? So there are some tomatoes, there are some capsicums, and there are some brinjals. Okay, so now the term classification means what? Categorizing things, putting things into different categories, right? So now in the table given below, you can see there is a table given here where you can see some tomato, a picture of tomato, then a brinjal, then a capsicum. So what you have to do is you have to count the number of tomatoes, count the number of capsicums, and count the number of brinjals and write in the appropriate box. Okay, so this like putting things into categories is called as classification. Now here you can see it is a mixed picture where there are different vegetables put in together. But in this table, what we have to do, we have to categorize, we have to classify each thing, and we have to write the appropriate number. Now, children, can you tell me what shall we write here in front of tomato? Like, what we have to do, we have to count the number of tomatoes, okay? So shall we start counting? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Very good. So there are 10 tomatoes in the picture. Very good. Now tell me, how many brinjals are there in the picture?
Five.
How many count? One. Very good. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Very good. So what are we going to write in this box? Fine. So the next picture of the vegetable is capsicum. So now tell me, how many capsicums is there? One, three. So now if we start writing, so how many tomatoes were there? Do you remember?
Ten.
Now how many people were there in the picture? How many?
Five.
Now see, do you remember how many capsicums were there in the picture?
Three.
So there were three capsicums. So yes, children, this is the way we need to classify things and we need to interpret the data and write down the numbers in the correct boxes, okay? So now we will move on to the next slide, okay? So now, children, can you see something on your screen?
Yes.
There are some pictures. Now, what are the pictures related to? Yes?
These pictures are with the beads, right?
Here you can see counting at the beads.
Five, six, seven.
First, you have to tell me what all things you can see in the picture. What are the things which you can see in the picture? Yes,
counting. There are some. Teacher, counting at the...
Counting at the beach. Matlab, the things which are given are related to beach. Now, you all have been visited to the beach. So, now there are some... In the picture, we'll just see. There are some pictures. There are some seashells given over here. There are balls. There are some tubes, water tubes. And these are the hot dogs that we get outside the beaches sometimes. And these are the castles, okay? Okay, so now what we have to do is we have to count each item and we have to write in the appropriate boxes. Okay, now the first picture is given, which is given over here is fish. What is the second picture? Yes, shell.
Shell.
The third is about castle. The third is castle, the castle which we make out of the mud, which we found on the beaches, okay? And the next picture is about the hot dog. And what did you find? Balls, okay? Football or something.
Football.
So now what we will do is we will count the number of objects and we will write in the appropriate boxes, okay? So now we will start counting. Okay, so how many fishes are there? Shall we start counting? Are you people ready? Are you children ready?
Yes.
Yes. So you have to count with me, okay? So we'll count the fishes. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So, yes, very good. So there are seven fishes in the picture. Very good. Now, what thing we have to count? We have to count the seashells. Okay, so how many seashells are there? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. What will we write here? Eight. So the number we are going to write here is eight. Now, how many castles is there? Only one we can see, right?
Only one.
It is there in the picture. So what are we going to write here?
Only one.
Now, what we have to count is the hot dogs. Now, how many hot dogs are there? See, one, two, three, four, five. So how many?
Five.
Now the next, water tube. How many water tubes are there?
One, two, three.
So here we are going to write three. Now,
eight.
Footballs. How many balls you can see in the picture?
One, two, three, four, five, six.
Very good. So when we write, so how many hot dogs were there? There were five hot dogs. There were three tubes. And there were how many balls? Six balls, okay? So we have done right now. We'll move to the next slide. Okay. So now students in this picture, tell me what you can see. It is a picture of a garden. What is the picture about? Okay. What is the picture about?
Yes. Garden.
Wherein. So there are some certain rules when we are observing the picture. Okay. So first, what we have to do, we have to identify what is the place about. So here the place is about a garden. Now, the second picture is, the second rule is we need to see what is going on in the picture. Who all are there in the picture? So here you can see there are some trees, there are some children, there is a bicycle. Now the third rule is, what are the people doing in the picture, right? So in the picture, the children, some children are playing kites, some are playing football, some are playing. So okay, so according to this, what we are going to do is, we are going to answer the question. Okay, so the first question is, look at the picture and fill in the blanks correctly. Okay, now you people have to observe the picture and you have to tell me the answer. Okay, it is very easy. Now the first question is, there are dash children in a park. Now tell me, children, how many children are there in the park? How many children?
Four.
Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4 and
five.
Okay, yes, so there are five. Very good. There are five children in the park. Very good. Now the next is, there are dash balls. So count the number of balls in the picture. How many balls are there?
Three balls.
Yes, very good. So 1, 2, and 3. So what are we going to write here? There are three balls. Okay. So the next question is, there are dash trees in the park. How many trees are there in the park, children? Yes?
Four.
Trees are there? Very good. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So there are four trees in the park. Very good. Now the next question, okay? There are dash bicycles. Now tell me, in the picture, where you can see the bicycle?
There are two bicycles.
Yes. So these are the bicycles, okay? So one bicycle, two bicycles. So how many bicycles? Two bicycles. Very good. Now the last question, okay? Dash boys are flying kites. So how many boys in the picture are flying kites?
Two kites.
Yes. So this is the first boy and this is the second boy who are flying kites. So what we are going to write here? Two. So when we write down the answer, so how many children were there? I want quick answers now. How many children were there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we are going to write here?
Five.
So there were how many balls? There were three balls. And there are dash trees in the park. There were four trees in the park. And there are dash bicycles. So there are two bicycles. And two boys were flying kites. Okay. Now we will move on to the next picture. So isn't the picture interesting, which you can see in the screen? Yes, children?
Yes, teacher.
So now tell me, we have already in the previous slide discussed like what are the rules of observing picture, right? So now tell me, the very first rule was, what is the picture about? Yes, tell me.
Bazaar.
Huh? Yes, very good. Bazaar. Very good. The picture.
Market.
Very good. Now the second rule of the picture observation was, like, how many, like, what all things you can see in the picture?
Fruits, vegetables.
Yes, very good. You can see fruits,
carrots, apples, banana.
Yes, very good. So you can see some carrots, bananas, some children, some men, some women. Yes, now the third rule of the picture observation was, like, which people, what people are doing, what all things, okay? So What are they doing that we have to observe? Now, can you just tell me what are the people doing? Now, look here, okay? Okay, there are some, humne, what we have discussed, it is a picture of a weekly market. Then there are some items like fruits, vegetables. There are people moving on, right? Now, the third thing was, what are they doing? Now, tell me, what is this auntie doing over here? What is this woman doing over here? Yes, what is she doing? Yes, she is selling vegetables. The children are buying something. This man is selling something, right? So this is the way like we have observed the picture. Now what we will do? We will move on to the questions, okay? So now in this slide, can you see the picture and some questions are given, okay? So what you have to do, you have to interpret data. You need to count some things. And you need to write down the answer in the appropriate blank, okay? So I'm going to read the questions now, okay? You have to answer. Now, observe the picture of the weekly market and fill in the blank correctly. Now, the first question is the number of vegetable carts. Now, tell me how many vegetable carts you can see in this picture? How many vegetable carts? See, here it is. 1, 2, 3, and 4. So how many vegetable carts are there in the picture? So there are 4 vegetable carts in the picture. Yes, can you hear me? Now the next question is the number of people selling fruits. Now, how many people are selling fruits? Yes. So, you can see this lady who's selling fruits, this man who's selling fruits, some apples, some bananas, right? So, there are 2 people who are selling fruits. Now, what is the third question? 4 fruits on sale in the market. So, now what we have to do? We have to look at the picture and we have to identify some of the fruits, okay? So what you have to do is some fruits like there are some pineapples, there are some apples, there are bananas, and there are oranges. So what we can write? Any 4 fruits which you can see in the picture. Now the next question is 5 vegetables being sold in the market. So can you name some of the vegetables which are being sold here? Yes. Can you name some of the vegetables? Yes. So there are some onions, potatoes, brinjal, carrots, and cabbages. So these are some of the vegetables which have been sold in the market. Now the next question is the number of boys in the market. So how many boys you can see in the picture? Yes. So there are, now see, here you can see the answers given, okay? So there are 3 boys, see, we will discuss, see. Yahan par you can see there are 3 boys in the market, 1, 2, and 3. And the next question is the number of girls in the market. So how many girls you can see in the market? 1 and 2. So there are 2 girls in the market. Now the last question is the number of people who have brought their own cloth bags to the market. Now you can see carrying plastic bags is like not allowed, so it is harmful to the environment. So here you can see there are some people carrying cloth bags, right? So here you can see, so how many people are carrying their own cloth bags? There are 1, 2, and 3. So there are 3 people who are carrying their cloth bags to their market. Okay. Now we have done with the first picture. Now we will move on to the next slide. Okay. So yes. So now children, what you can see in this picture? What you can see in this picture? Yes. So there are some vehicles, there is a road, where you can see signals are there. Some vehicles are moving. Some are just waiting for the signal to go. Right? You can see the zebra crossing. Yes. So this is a picture of a road wherein you can see different sort of vehicles which are moving, which are waiting for the signal. Right? So in this picture, what we have to do, as you can see, we will first just classify, we will just segregate the things, and we are going to count down the vehicles and we are going to write down the appropriate number. Now, the first picture which you can see is of a bicycle, okay? Now, count how many bicycles you can see in the picture. How many bicycles you can see? Yes, so there is one bicycle. And how many bicycles? Yes, there is only one. So what we are going to write here? One. Now, the second picture is about motorcycle. Now, in this picture, how many motorcycles you can see? Yes, there are two motorcycles, the one and the second one. So here you're going to write down two. Now, how many cars you can see in the picture? One, two, and three. So there are three cars in the picture. So what are we going to write here? Three. Now, how many buses you can see? Yes, where are the bus? Where is the bus? Yes, there is only one bus in the picture. So what are we going to write here? One. Now, auto rickshaw. Now tell me, how many auto rickshaws are there in the picture? This is the first one and this is the second one. So there are two auto rickshaws in the picture. So there was one bicycle, then two motorbikes, and three cars, one bus, and two auto rickshaw. Okay, now we will move on to the next slide. Now see, what is given over here? On the left-hand side, you can see the picture, and on the right-hand side, you can see certain questions are given, right? So we will read the first question. Name the vehicles that have stopped at the red signal. Now tell me, yes, in this picture you can see there are some vehicles and there are signals, right? Yes, the corners you can see. Now the question is, name the vehicles that have stopped at the red signal. Red signal means what? The vehicles need to wait. Okay. So see, what you have to do, you have to find out which vehicles are waiting. Which vehicles are waiting at the red signal, yes? Who's going to answer? Yes, so there is a car who's waiting here. Then another car who's waiting here. Then an auto rickshaw and a motorbike, okay? So two cars, one motorbike, and one auto rickshaw are waiting at the red signal. Now the second question, okay? So the second question is, which vehicles are moving at the green signal? Now when the color is green, so what does that indicate? That indicates that the vehicles of that direction can move. Now in this picture, tell me which vehicles are moving. Which are the vehicles which are moving? Yes? So, what we can see here. See, the bus is moving at the green signal. The motorbike is moving. Then, the bicycle even, he is starting to move. And the car and the auto rickshaw. So, which vehicles are moving at the green signal? The answer will be one bus, a car, one bicycle, one motorbike and one auto rickshaw. These are the vehicles which are moving at the green signal. Now the next question is, which vehicles in the picture cause air pollution? Now air pollution, right, means the vehicles, like all vehicles cause air pollution because the smoke which comes out from the vehicles causes air pollution. Now in this picture, which sort of vehicles we have seen?
Yes.
We have seen buses, cars, motorbikes, bikes, but there is a bicycle, right? Now all the vehicles which use fuels like petrol, diesel, and CNG, to a lesser quantity, but still they cause air pollution, because what does the fuel does? It brings out the smoke into the atmosphere, and that causes air pollution. So in bicycles, we do not use any sort of fuel. Okay, so the answer will be, which vehicles in the picture cause air pollution? So the answer will be all vehicles except bicycle, because bicycle does not use any sort of fuel. Okay, so the answer will be all vehicles except bicycle causes air pollution. Now the next question is, which of the vehicles, that is amongst the bicycles, motorcycles, cars, buses, and auto rickshaws, are most in the number? Now, what does the word most mean? Okay, the number most means more in number. Now you have seen in the picture, there were, in the very first slide, what we did, we categorized different sort of vehicles, right? So in this and that, what we did, we counted the number of vehicles and we wrote in the boxes. Okay, so there were buses, there were three cars, and there were two motorbikes, and there were two auto rickshaws, and there was one bicycle. So now tell me, which is the most vehicles found in the picture? Most means sabse zyada, right? So there are three cars. So the answer will be cars, because it is three in number, which is maximum in the picture. Okay. So in this slide, you can just go through the answers, like which we have discussed in the previous slide. Okay, cars and vehicles, there are the answers which we have discussed. Okay, so have you seen? Do you have any doubts in the slide? Okay, so the picture was about the signal rules, the vehicle moving, and the most number of vehicles which we have seen, right? Now we will move on to the next slide. Okay, so now students, children, just tell me what you can see in the picture. Yes, what you can see in the picture? There are some lovely mouth watering like dishes of food items which are there in the picture. There are some bread, there are some donuts, there are some cupcakes, right? Right, there are different food items which you can see in the picture. Now, what we have to do is we have to classify these things. We need to count the number of things, food items, and we have to write in front of the box, which we have done already, right? So it is a revision. So now tell me, how many bread are there in the picture? Yes? How many breads are there in the picture? Yes? Count and tell me. Yes, so there are 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 breads in the picture. So when we are writing here, we are going to write here 5 breads. Now tell me, how many donuts are there in the picture? These are the donuts, right? So we need to count the donuts and we need to write it in the box. So now tell me quickly, how many donuts are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and 11. So there are 11 donuts in the picture. Now tell me, how many cupcakes are there in the given picture? How many cupcakes are there? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So there are 7 cupcakes in the picture. So what we are going to write? We are going to write down the numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bread. So we are going to write here 5. How many donuts were there? There were 11 donuts. Okay. Now how many cupcakes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So how many cupcakes? 7. Okay. So now what we have done? We have counted the numbers. We have segregated different food items. Now we will read out the question and then we will find out the answer. Now the first question is, which is the fewest in number? Now fewest in number means what? Fewest means subject less. Ekdam kam. Okay. So now tell me, which is the fewest in number? The very small number is 5. So the food item which is fewest in number will be bread. Okay. Now the next question is, how many more donuts did they buy than cupcakes? How many more? Okay, so two items are given, donuts and cupcakes, right? So which is more? Donuts. So what we have to do, we have to subtract 7 from 11. So what will be the answer? How many more? So 8, 9, 10, 11. So the answer will be 4 donuts are more than cupcake. Now the next question, which item counts more than 8? Now more than 8, which is the food item which is more than 8? Breads are 5, cupcakes are 7, but the 11 number is greater than 8, right? So yahan pe, what will be the answer? Which item counts more than 8? So the answer will be donuts. Okay. Now the last question, how many items are there in all? Now in all means the total number of food items they have asked. So in the picture which you can see, the bread, the cupcakes and the donuts, what we have to do is we have to add all these numbers and we have to write down the total in the last answer. So there are 5 breads, 11 donuts, and 7 cupcakes. So what are we going to do? We are going to add all these 3 numbers and we are going to write down the answer over here. So what is 5 plus 11 plus 7? Yes. So the answer is 23. Now see on this slide, you can see the answers. The fewest item is the bread. Now donuts, how many more donuts were there than the cupcakes? There were 4 donuts. And which item counts more than 8 was the donuts. And how many items are there in all? There are 23 food items which we can see in the above picture. Now, yes, students, I hope you have understood the topic. The interesting topic which we have learned today was reading pictures, interpreting the data from the given picture. So have you all understood? Do you have any doubt? Okay, so shall we end now? Shall we end? So I hope you might have understood how to interpret data from the given picture and how to observe the picture, the rules of observing the picture and answering the questions related to it. Now, I hope you have enjoyed the lesson. Thank you for joining the lesson and answering the questions. Okay, thank you so much.